you sent me down a Scientology rabbit hole last night, my friend.
Perhaps the biggest obstacle to making a documentary about Scientology is the overabundance of material. You can just chase intriguing leads, and then months go by, and you're no nearer to filming anything.
Scientology. You don't wanna slide to the hillside, yeah, yeah. You gon' keep it right for the hillside, yeah, yeah. When it's late at night, see my real side. Baby, that's the real side. Baby, that's the real side. You don't wanna slide to the hillside, yeah, yeah. You gon' keep it right for the hillside, yeah, yeah. When it's late at night, see my real side. Baby, that's the real side. Baby, that's the real side. You don't wanna slide to the real side. You can bring a bottle to the hillside. You see me at night, that's my real side. Any of my enemies should feel you, yeah. So can we get it started for the hillside? Throw myself a party on the hillside. It's any and Patron on the real side. That's the hillside. Any shit for you, yeah. Riding through the city in a band, oh yeah. I can do the things that he can't, oh yeah. Hillside, baby, that's the real side. That's the chill side, baby, that's the hillside.
Free personality test, it's fun and it's free. Free personality test. You there, would you like to try this personality test? Okay, then I guess one test wouldn't do any harm. That's great! Come this way, follow me. It'll only take a second of your time. Hello, handshake. My name is... What's your name? Tells. Nice to meet you. Put cans in hands. Here's how this works. Listen, man, I really don't think this is going to work. I need to get going.
Wait!
Do you know who else is Scientologist? Lots of cool people are Scientologists. Like Tom Cruise and John Travolta. And Charles Manson, but don't bring that up. How do I sign up? That's great! It's very easy. Just sign this document and we'll make a Scientologist out of you in no time. What's in it? Ah, nothing special. Just acknowledgement that you won't sue us. And of course that. It's a religion. You hate psychology. The church is not obligated to return donations. The church may compile a folder about you, which is the sole and exclusive property of the church. Said folder is kept confidential even from you. The e-media does nothing, and of course you agree that the application of any Scientology or Dianetics technology or practice might not have any particular effect on you or any other person. I guess that's reasonable. Wanna join the Sea Org and sign a billion-year contracts as well?
How many times have you been married?
How many times have I been married? I've been married twice. And I'm very happily married just now. I have a lovely wife and I have four children. My first wife is dead.
What happened to your second wife?
I never had a second wife.
Calling the 1940s a difficult time to live in would be the understatement of the decade. World War II would continue on for 5 years, leaving tens of millions dead in the process. The horrors the survivors of the war would encounter would follow them the rest of their lives. You might not see how this in any way relates to L.Ron Hubbard. Don't worry, I'm getting to it. L.Ron Hubbard and his ties to a satanic sex cult. L.Ron Hubbard was an esteemed science fiction writer, a man so dedicated to his craft that he would receive several Guinness Book of World Records, including most published works by one author. He truly was one of a kind. He also believed that tomatoes feel pain and that if it's quiet enough, you can hear them scream when they're sliced. According to Hubbard, he was abandoned by family and friends as a supposedly hopeless cripple and a probable burden upon them for the rest of his days. Hubbard had served the United States Navy Reserve from 1941 up until 1945 and then ultimately resigning in 1950 due to the success of his book Dianetics. In August 1945, Hubbard moved into the Pasadena mansion owned by John Parsons, a rocket engineer who invented the first rocket engine to use a blah 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 blah, not important. To put it plainly, this guy was the Michael Morbius of the scientific community. Parsons would later go on to die at the age of 37 due to complications from explosion. It's believed that he accidentally blew himself up, most likely due to the fact that he was probably high on morphine at the time. But like most of the characters in the story, others theorized that the explosion was a planned assassination plot. Parsons was a troubled character. We can only hope that he finally found a place to rest in peace in hell, I guess. Parsons was also a big fan of science fiction, so he decided to let Hubbard join him and let him participate in his orgy parties. Parsons believed that the moment of orgasm was so powerful that if you experience an orgasm whilst focusing your intention, you could make magic happen. He would later set out to prove this hypothesis of his with the help of actor Marjorie Cameron. The two of them set out to birth the Antichrist, and with the help of Hubbard, who was forced to watch, the gang would surely succeed, right? Well, Hubbard would leave the Pasadena mansion, and with him, he brought Parsons' girlfriend, who was enamored by Hubbard and his stories of being a war hero with 21 medals and injuries he had gained during the war. As he said, he had been abandoned by family due to said injuries. Unbeknownst to her, this was all lies. Official records show that he never actually left the United States during the war. He lost the command of his ship due to several mishaps. He was allowed to stay in the Navy on inactive duty until 1950, when he left due to the success of Dianetics.
Do you use drugs in any way?
No, never. Once in a while, Scientologists will take vitamins or something like that to, just like anybody else does, but otherwise, no drugs. I love cocaine!
Dianetics, the modern science of mental health, was Hubbard's claim to fame. This was the book that truly brought him into the mainstream for a time. The book became a nationwide bestseller, selling over 150,000 copies within a year. So what exactly is it about?
Man has an automobile accident. He has a picture of an automobile accident. He has all the sensations of having been hurt in the automobile accident. It takes him a long time to recover because he's still wearing the automobile accident. If you said, hey, why don't you take this automobile accident and throw it away? Why all of a sudden he recovers from the automobile accident.
Yeah, I know. This guy's a genius! Have you been exposed to lethal amounts of nuclear radiation? Just don't think about it. I guess it would make sense that the world's biggest scientific breakthrough would be that simple. It is weird though, no scientist was even close to proving this before Hubbard came along. I guess it's because of how stupid it is. On a serious note, this thing, believe it or not, has absolutely no basis in reality. Despite its success, Dianetics was heavily criticized by scientists, who, if you can believe it, had some issues with the statement, Dianetics will cure your leukemia, bro, just don't think about it.
The Church of Scientology refers to Anonymous as a group of cyber terrorists. They say they're simply protesting the church and that they're harmless.
Never gonna give you up, never gonna let you down, never gonna run.
The year is 2008. At this point, Scientology had avoided a tax debt said to be around $1 billion due to their targeting of individual IRS employees. The CIA was investigating them and South Park was satirizing them. It was only natural then that Scientology's everlasting feud with absolutely everybody would make its way down to the depths of humanity. Having gone after every stable member of society, the next opponent would prove to be the greatest one yet.
You're either helping, contributing everything you can, or you're not, okay? Because I'm carrying my load, all right? And then it's a blast. It's a blast. It really is fun. Because damn it, there's nothing better than to going out there and fighting a fight and suddenly you see...
It's just...
In 2008, this video of Tom Cruise would leak. Scientology wanted this video removed, but how would they go about this? You can't just wipe the video from existence because that inherently makes it more interesting and encourages people to go look for it. There's no way in the year 2008 anybody would make the same mistake that Barbara Streisand had made 5 years prior. I mean, nobody would be that stupid. Scientologists sent takedown notices to sites hosting the video, effectively wiping it from the web. People on 4chan quickly noticed and a call to action was later sent out. I think it's time for B to do something big. I'm talking about hacking or taking down the official Scientology website. It's time to use our resources to do something we believe is right. 4chan was going to war. Apart from the protests on the streets, 4chan would also use other methods to attack the church. A special operation was also about to go down.
Brave Agent Cupid, He was about to arrive at the Church of Scientology. His target could not hide. Touch everyone and everything once he runs inside. Pubes on their hands as they go to grab the gross, slippery, puke-covered guy.
Scientology and its way of dealing with detractors differs heavily from other types of religions. If you're a person that the church deems to be a threat, then you're fair game. Individuals or groups who are fair game are judged to be a threat to the church, and according to the policy, can be punished and harassed using any and all means possible. This policy was officially cancelled in 1968 due to bad publicity. Although it was cancelled, Scientologists seemingly still operate under the same kind of mentality of fair game.
Stop committing suppressive acts. Full-time suppressive act is full-time, and nobody gives a fuck about you. That's the truth. You're nothing.
No conflict.
You guys gonna stick around here?
Yeah, Marty, we're here for weeks. Weeks and weeks.
As long as it takes.
Starting in the 1980s, the Scientology organization largely switched from using church members in harassment campaigns to hiring private investigators, including former and current Los Angeles police officers. With that context in mind, I want to talk about South Park.
Okay, Stan, well, that's it. That's the end of the personality test.
So how'd I do?
I'm afraid that you are completely miserable and totally depressed. Well, there's certainly no question that you are a perfect candidate for Scientology. I think it can really make you happy again.
What do I do?
It's very simple. We just need $240.
Matt Stone and Trey Parker are no strangers to mocking religion.
Buddha, don't do coke in front of kids!
Because of this willingness to go after everyone, it's to no one's surprise that the two eventually would make fun of Scientology. Which they did. The episode set out to mock not only the religion, but also Tom Cruise. This episode allegedly struck such a nerve with the church's leaders that the group responded by targeting Stone, Parker, and their friends. This was their findings. Trey Parker drives a gray Altima. They have celebrity friends. Yeah, that's it. This is Tommy Davis, a representative of Scientology. And this is an infamous interview he did with CNN, where he discussed the protesters, among other things. I wanted to include this because the church's very inhumane rule of disconnection, which involves completely separating members of the church from the people who are declared to be SPs or suppressive persons.
They claim that the church separates family members, and there is this practice of disconnection.
Well, and first of all, this is a perfect example of how the internet turns things and twists things. There's no such thing as disconnection as you're characterizing it. Anything that's characterized as disconnection or this kind of thing, it's just not true. There isn't any such policy that in the church that's dictating who people should or should not be in communication with. You know, it just doesn't happen.
As you just heard, there is no such thing as disconnection in the church. If the spokesman for the church says that it isn't a thing, what authority do I have to disagree with him? It's not like I have any evidence to substantiate my claims. There's a secret recording of him threatening to disconnect a member of the church.
Scientology is the only thing in between us. Cool. Look, same with my mom, I'm assuming, but I haven't spoken to either of them actually specifically about why we're not in better calm, but
you've spoken to your sister.
All the time, yeah.
Anyway, I think I've sort of said my piece. I'm raising the key policies that are either one in terms of organizational suppressive acts.
Yeah.
LRH puts it in historical precedent as it relates to groups, period, not just to Scientology. There's a reason groups do this, they think of the survival. Groups who don't do it get destroyed. And it's just been proven over and over and over again in Scientology's 58-year history that, to whatever degree, SPs scream about how horrible it is. Bottom line, it is what works, it is what safeguards the church, and by virtue of the fact that people who are connected to suppressives do roller coaster, cannot make gains, and are called potential sources of trouble or sources of trouble for a reason based on historical precedents. It isn't a policy that is going to change tomorrow, next week, next month, whatever. So,
yeah, it's unfortunate, but you're right.
Maybe for you, I'd like to see the church keep going. And in order for it to be able to, it has to protect itself.
Do you ever think that you might be quite mad?
Oh, yes. The one man in the world who never believes he's mad is a madman.
It's almost 70 years ago today that the Church of Scientology opened its doors, and a lot has happened since then. Mainly the internet, which in my opinion has been what dealt the hardest blow to Scientology. Scientology is a religion that relies on secrets. This business model has worked tremendously well for Scientology, which has become a billion-dollar business. But with the rise of the internet, Scientology can no longer hide those secrets that made them into the behemoth that they are today. You can now read the story of Xenu and the volcanoes with just one simple Google search. You don't have to spend $500,000. You can just watch a YouTube video. Getting a good estimate on how many people are currently practicing Scientologist isn't easy, especially if you take the church's word for it. Since the forming of the Church of Scientology in 1954, religion has grown to span the globe. Today, more than 10,000 Scientology churches, missions, related organizations, and affiliated groups minister to millions in 165 countries. The estimates I keep seeing from everybody who isn't Scientology.org puts the size of the religion in the 20, maybe 30 thousands. 20,000 people is by no means a small number, don't get me wrong, but I think it speaks volumes that more people consider themselves Jedi.
Thank you for listening. I write just for you. But others hearing this may find things they would argue.
This film and walk out and never mention Scientology again, you are perfectly free to do so. It would be stupid, but you can do it. You can also dive off a bridge or blow your brains out.